But it's so great to see your smiling faces. Some of you, I've seen your smiles for the first time, and that's really cool. So welcome to Leo on this very special day. It's my privilege to welcome James Anker and Unclouded Day, and I hope that you'll enjoy the ministry that they bring us as much as I have listening to them start up. Just a few quick announcements. We're all good on social distancing. You are kind of responsible for that yourself. We've got some areas that are roped off so that you can remain socially distant, and masks are optional, so we're all excited about that. So without further ado, Unclouded Day.
I'm gonna go to the Jubilee. Well, good morning, Leo Church.
Good morning.
Good morning, Leo Church.
Good morning.
Are you having fun already?
Yes.
Yeah. Wasn't Bill just absolutely fabulous on that last week? We purposely have been putting that song early in our program so you get to enjoy him right away. And then a little later, we're going to feature some of our really good soloists. We're so happy to be here. And the very first thing we want to say to you is what a lovely, lovely renovation you've done. This is just beautiful and so inviting. I think you should give yourself a round of applause for this beautiful sanctuary. So we've been singing since 1989. We started out as a chords vocal ensemble. We sang here a few years as a chords vocal ensemble. But in 2016, we made a couple changes, and we're now Unclouded Day. And here is the song that talks about there will be an unclouded day when we all reach heaven. Here we go. So we're going to start off easy today. we're going to start off easy. When we point to you to join us in Jesus Loves Me, there'll be no mamby-pamby singing. There'll be no none of that.
You're going to sing.
Will you do that for me?
Sure.
Will you sing for us today?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, here we go. How many of you played football when you were young?
Thank you.
Remain seated and sing the refrain to In the Garden a little later.
Thank you. Amen.
Back of the book, the book of Revelation.
double dutch.
So you know Mark Westerhausen used to sing with this song.
Yeah.
We had to put him on the end because he could never figure out a microphone cord. He just got totally confused. So
that's why Carl's not there.
Where's your lovely bride this morning?
She's on vacation.
Oh. She's on vacation.
Yes. With some girlfriends in Punta Gorda.
I see.
Punta Cana.
So a vacation from you, Mark.
Yes. Yes. I think you can understand that.
What? Was she not aware that I would be here this morning?
I think that's why she went.
So we sing a lot of New Testament music. A lot of music about the resurrection, about Jesus' ministry on earth. But of course, there's an entire Old Testament that we also need to be aware of and praise. And this song's called Old Jeremiah. Old Jeremiah. But there are 22 prophets mentioned in this song. And three of them are female. Not a very good ratio. Seems like if we'd had a few more, we may have gotten a little further, a little quicker. But 22, see if you can catch them on. Oh, Jeremiah.
Oh, Jeremiah, open up the door.
name the three female prophets that we spoke of? Miriam, Deborah, and well, we didn't say Hannah. You may have misunderstood us. Haggai, Miriam, and Deborah. So, when we come next time, there'll be a quiz. We'll send out a little piece of paper. You want to check them off and find them. I guess I'm supposed to be playing, so I better get up here and play. Go ahead.
Thank you.
from Jared Rusko. And you've already met our piano player, but he deserves at least another round of applause. This is Alexander. All the way from St. Mary's, Ohio, a fabulous, nifty guy and drummer. This is Mr. Dane Newla.
He's so nifty.
And then playing trumpet all the way down from Decatur, Indiana, a dear friend of mine, a great trumpet player, flugelhorn player, and also works at my next on instruments. This is Patrick Nash. And I wanted to say, Tony, for the last, wasn't that solo that he played in the beginning of that song great? A round of applause for Mr. Tony Alstree. To record four CDs. We have four different CDs for you to choose from. My lovely wife, who's standing in the doorway there, would be happy to help you out underneath the cross of flames. And our CDs are inexpensive on purpose. They're $10 for one, they're $25 for three, and they're $40, that wouldn't be a good deal, $30 for all four. Now, how many car makers today, if you go out and buy a new car, have a CD player in them? One, Subaru. That's the only car maker that still has a CD player. So you may say, well, James, you folks are a little behind the times. You've got these CDs, and you're wanting us to purchase them. Well, here's what I want you to do. I want you to take our CDs and purposely steal our music. Just download it all on your computer, on your MP3 player, or whatever it is that people do nowadays. And then I want you to box it back up, and I want you to hand that CD to the person that you invite to this church in the next 2 weeks. And say, as my gift to you for coming and joining us this morning, I want you to enjoy this CD. These folks were with us a few weeks ago, and we enjoyed it. We hope that you will. Just steal it from us and give it to someone who needs to hear the gospel of Jesus Christ. Will you do that?
Amen.
Well, I got one amen. Will you do that?
Yeah.
Yeah. And I'm serious. And if you need a CD and you can't afford it, then you just go to Mark Westerhaus and he'll buy it for
you. Well, you're not catching a break tonight.
This is the title track to this is the title track to our third CD. It's called In God We Still Trust.
Source of all our strength, the one who watches over.
just a couple tunes left for you. Thank you for not applauding. We call this our mini Unclouded Day hit medley. Because of all the radio play we've gotten all over the United States that we wish would happen. And we need a pinch hitter. I didn't play baseball, I was a swimmer. And I was gorgeous. we will tell you what he
I'm thought. Sure you were, Jason.
Mark sang with us. I was going to do a real fancy introduction, but Carl called you up here, and I don't know why you're paying attention. Carl, he's not in charge of anything. Mark sang with us for many, many, many years, and then he had grandchildren and work and all that, and he had to step aside, but I know that he misses it because I saw him smiling this morning when we were running through this tune. Let me tell you about Mark Westerhausen.
Oh, boy.
Strap it up.
You didn't get the blue
one. When you're the director of a music group, there are always people behind the scenes in the ensemble who growl about you. You know, can't believe Zanker does that. Can you believe Zanker does this? Why is he like that? But you know what? Not from Mark Westerhausen. He never said anything negative about me or anyone else in the group. And I know you know that about him, don't you? He's a positive person. And what better song to feature him singing with us than this little light of mine, because you, look at there, you have always been, Mark's my best, my first friend in Fort Wayne. He's the very first person that I, outside of Patrick, who I worked with, and we've been friends ever since, and I love it when we talk to each other on the phone, because we may not talk for 2 years, but I say, good morning. And he says, good morning. I said, how are you doing? He says, doing great. And from there on, we just talk about whatever's happening in our lives. And Mark, you've been a great friend to me. You've been a great friend to everyone up here. And right now, we're going to sing this little light of mine. Here we go.
Anybody blow it out, no, I'm gonna let it shine.
But did you notice that Mark's mic still has Mark's name on it?
Well, it's because I always want Caden to have his mic when he comes back.
It's so cool.
I'll tell you what. All we have to do is just convince Karen that Mark needs to be seen again, so that's all we got to do. We'll take you anytime, friend. Anytime. Pastor.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Benedict.
All right.
So when you're reading a review of a restaurant that's undervalued and it says best kept secret, that's a great thing for a restaurant that needs more attention. These guys, best kept secret, I think it applies. I think they need to be more well known. So could we recognize them one more time? Give you peace and strength for the journey. This man every day, and all of God.